Good morning, dear students. I hope you all are fine. Today, we are going to start grammar topic determiners. Now, let us see what are determiners. Determiners are the words that specify a noun and point at it. The word which specifies a noun and points at that noun. Such words are called determiners. Determiners are always placed before noun. Now let us see the kinds of determiners. First is articles, that is a, an, the. These are articles. Next is demonstratives, this, that, these and those. Next is distributives, either, neither, each, every. Possessives, my, our, your, his, her, etc. Quantifiers, some, any, much, several. And interrogative, what, which, whose, how much, etc. So these are different kinds of determiners. Now let us see all this in detail one by one. So let us first understand what is the difference between an adjective and determiner. So the first difference is an adjective qualifies a noun and describes it. What does adjective do? It qualifies the noun. It tells something more about the noun. It describes the noun, right? And determiner specifies the noun and points to it. Determiner specifies, whereas adjective qualifies, okay? Example, she is pretty girl. Now this is an adjective, pretty. This girl has stood first in class. So this is determiner, right? Now what does adjective tell? Adjective tells some special qualities of noun and tells what kind of person or thing is meant. Okay? So it tells about special quality or what kind. And determiners tells us which one. Determiners tells us which one. This, that. Okay, so which one. Next, the form of adjective can change. For example, weak, weaker, weakest, tall, taller, tallest. So in this way, the form of adjective can change, but determiners remains the same. They do not change. We cannot say any, right? So they remain the same. Next, now let us see the position. The position of an adjective is before a noun or a complement of a noun. So it can be before a noun or it can be as a complement of a noun, whereas the position of determiners is always before the noun. So this is the difference between an adjective and determiner. Now let us see the first kind of determiner, that is articles. Now what is article? Articles a, an, and the are determiners that indicate the coming of nouns. Now they are determiners which indicate the coming of nouns. Okay. For example, the flowers in the garden look colorful. Give me a book to read. So the and a, these are what? These are articles. Now articles are of two types. One is definite and the other is indefinite. Okay. A and an, they are indefinite articles. Why are they indefinite articles? Because they do not indicate any particular thing or place. They are used in general. They do not indicate any particular, any specific thing or place. So they are called as indefinite articles. Example, a dog is barking. An apple fell from the tree. So we are talking about any general dog or any apple. We are not specifying which apple or which dog. So we have used the article a and an. Now next is definite article, that is the. The is definite article because it points to particular person, thing or place. So when we point out towards something specific, we use definite article the. And when we talk about in general, we use indefinite article a or an. Now article the can be used with both singular and plural nouns. They can be used with singular and plural nouns, whereas articles a and an are used with singular countable nouns. They are used with singular countable nouns, and the is used with singular or plural nouns and even with uncountable nouns. Now let's move ahead. Now let us see examples of indefinite articles. Now indefinite articles, now the use of a is used before a noun beginning with consonant sound. Okay, the nouns which begins with consonants or consonant sounds, we use the article a. For example, a boy. So boy begins with the consonant b, right? Next, a European. E is a vowel, right? Then why we have used a and why not an? Because the pronunciation is u. It doesn't have the vowel sound. Even the word begins with a vowel, it doesn't have vowel sound, and so we write a European and not an European. Okay. Now an is used before the noun beginning with vowel and vowel sound. So we use an before a vowel sound. Example, an apple, an R. Now you will say that H here is H, which is a consonant, but why an then? H is silent here, and so it is an R. Okay. Now let us see how this indefinite articles a and an are used. Now a and an is used to indicate a single entity, means for singular nouns. For example, a bag, a car, one, for single thing. Okay. Next, second, it is used to express certain quantity. To express certain quantity. For example, a dozen eggs, a cup of sugar. Okay. So to indicate certain quantity, also we use indefinite article. Next is to show rank, profession or community. To show rank, profession or community. For example, a Muslim, this is a community. Okay. A doctor, profession. So to show rank, profession or community, we use indefinite article. Next use is to indicate any for identifying an individual as the representative of a class. So if you want to identify an individual as a representative of a class, we use indefinite article. Example, a child should obey his parents. Now here, a child. So we are not talking about any one particular child. We are talking about any child. And for denoting that, we use indefinite article. Next is, before a proper name to point out an unfamiliar person. Before a proper name to point out an unfamiliar person. A Sonali Sharma wants to meet you. Or if you want to express a special meaning. If you want to express special meaning, for example, he thinks he is a Sonu Nigam. Now here we are expressing a special meaning. And for that we use indefinite article. We also use indefinite articles in the expressions like a mess, a pity, a lot of work, etc. I hope you have understood the use of indefinite article A and an. A is used with singular, countable, but there is a condition beginning with consonant sound. An is used with singular, countable, the words beginning with vowel sound. Okay. Now let us see the definite article the. Now the is used before a definite noun, a specific noun, where when to make it particular. If we are talking about someone particular, at that time we use the definite article the. Example is, the butterfly which flew into the room was pink. Now we are talking about particular butterfly. Which butterfly which flew into the room? So we are talking about the particular butterfly which flew into the room, and so we have used the definite article the. Next, the can be used with countables, cars, books, and with uncountables, information also. So the is used with countable as well as uncountable noun, but a and an are used only with countable nouns. So that is the difference. Next, it can also be used with singular countable nouns or plural countable nouns. Okay. So the can be used with singular as well as plural, but a and an are only used with singular. Next, it is used before an adjective when it represents a class or is used as a noun. So when it represents a class or when it is used as a noun, we use definite article the. For example, the rich. Now we are talking about the people who are rich, the class of people who are rich. So we use the. The poor. The lucky. Okay, so we are talking about a class. The rich should help the poor. Okay. Next, the is used before a common noun to represent a whole class. So to represent a whole class, also we use the. For example, the tiger is a cruel animal. Now here we are not talking about any one tiger, we are talking about all the tigers. So the, it is used to represent the whole category of tiger, right? The fox is cunning animal. So we use the. Let's move towards our next slide. The is used before an adjective when it shows quality. So when it shows quality, at that time also we use the. For example, the beauty of flowers is amazing. So we are showing the quality, the beauty, that is a quality, right? So when it shows quality, we use the before it. Then we also use the in superlative degrees. For example, it is the smallest bird in the zoo. So smallest is a superlative degree. So before superlative degree also we use the. Next, it is also used before a noun to show unit of measure. To show a unit of measure. For example, eggs are sold by the dozen. So dozen is a unit of measurement, right? Milk is sold by the liter. Liter is the unit of measurement. So before the unit of measurement as well, we use definite article the. Next, we use definite article the before the direction and common nouns that are unique. Directions and common nouns that are unique. Okay, for example, the east, now this is direction, the west, the earth. The earth is a unique noun. The moon, unique noun. The planets, they are unique. So before unique nouns or before the directions, we use the. Let's move ahead. Now, the is also used before certain common nouns. Now, before which common nouns? For example, the cinema, the temple, the theater. So, these are common nouns. Before some common nouns as well, we use the. I often go to the theater with my family. Next. The is used with a noun that has already been mentioned. So the noun which has already been mentioned, for that also we use the. For example, I bought a vase from the shop. Okay, now here a vase, right? But now this vase is already mentioned. So next time when we write vase, we use the article the vase. Now, because we are talking about this particular vase which is already mentioned, and so here we use the vase. The vase is beautiful. Next, it is also used when it is clear from the situation which people or thing we mean. So when we know, when we are clear about which people or about which situation we are talking about, at that time we use definite article the. For example, the teacher is in the class. So we know we are talking about that particular teacher. We know which teacher we are talking about, right? So we use definite article the. Next, it is also used with such phrases that specify a person or object. So the phrases which specify a person or object, with those phrases we use the. The first house. Now the first house is a phrase. So we use the. The only baby. The same pen. The main purpose. The next person. So with the phrases also we use the. Let's move towards our next slide. Now, the is also used with the names of seas or oceans. For example, the Arabian Sea, the Pacific Ocean, right? The Atlantic Ocean. then it is used with holy books, the Ramayana, the Bible, the Quran, right? Then used with trains, ships and aeroplanes. Now, for example, the Rajdhani Express, the Emirates. Rajdhani Express is a train, the Emirates is a plane, right? Then it is used with the name of the rivers, the Ganga, the Yamuna, the Brahmaputra, etc. It is also used with mountain ranges, the Alps, the Himalayas. See, it is used, the is used with mountain ranges. The is not used with a single mountain. We cannot say the Mount Everest. Then it is also used with the names of newspapers, the Times of India, the India Times, the Hindustan Times, etc. Now, the is also used with the countries if the name has a common noun. So, if the name has a common noun, it is a group, then we use the United Kingdom, the United States of America. Next, for some important buildings as well, we use the. For example, the Taj Mahal, the Qutub Minar, the Red Fort, so and so. Next, the is also used with the names of the whole families, the Guptas, the Kapoors, the Mauryas, etc. Then last is, we use the with expression like on the other hand, so the is here, speak the truth, to play the guitar, the more the merrier. So with these expressions, we use the as well. Let's move ahead. Now, omission of article a, an and the means where we should not use the articles. It is omitted before a proper noun. For example, Mahendra Singh Dhoni leads the Indian cricket team. We cannot see the Mahendra Dhoni. It will be wrong. So before proper noun, it is article is omitted. It is also omitted before plural nouns when such nouns denote a class. Plural nouns which denote a class. Before that, we omit the articles. For example, children. Children is a plural noun which denotes a class. So we don't use the here. Children love ice cream. Birds eat worm. Okay. Next is, we don't use article with family relations. For example, when noun depicts family relations with respect to the speaker, because they are used like proper nouns in such situations. Now, why we don't use before family relations? Because they are used as a proper noun. They are used like proper nouns, and you know that before proper nouns we do not use articles. For example, father loves to play cricket. We can't say the father, right? Mother is planning to go to the market. Next, we don't use articles with abstract nouns. Or honesty is a great quality. So honesty is a abstract noun. We don't use article before it. Then we don't use article before the names of games. For example, we love to play cricket. We can't say we love to play the cricket. No, we love to play cricket. Chess is my favorite game. So before name of games also, we don't use articles. Next, languages or branches of knowledge. So before languages or before branches of knowledge, we don't use the article. For example, I have learned French in New Delhi. Now I have learned French. French is a language. So before that, we don't use article. I like to study science. Hindi is my mother tongue. So before the name of languages, we don't use articles. Next, we don't use articles with names of meals. Which are the meals? Lunch, dinner, brunch, right? So before the names of meals also we don't use articles. For example, we would like to have lunch. Okay. Next, names of diseases. For names of diseases also we do not use the article. For example, she was suffering from malaria. Malaria is a name of a disease, so we have not used any article before it. Then names of days, months and seasons. Before them also article is not used. For example, Monday is a working day. Monday is the name of a day. January is the coldest month in Delhi. So before the names of days, months, seasons, we do not use article. Next, we do not use articles in headlines, messages, emails, etc. For example, new bridge inaugurated by Chief Minister. New bridge inaugurated by Chief Minister. We have not mentioned here. We have not used any article here. Next, unidentified bag found at the bus stop. So, unidentified bag found at the bus stop. Okay. Next, we do not use articles with common nouns when they denote institutions in general. So, common nouns, when they denote institutions in general, we do not use article. For example, when I was in school, my mother used to be my teacher. When I was in school, my mother used to be my teacher. School is a common noun which denotes an institution. So, we have not used any article here. Let us move ahead. Now all I have told about the omission of articles, but now we can also use article before the proper noun if we write Shlok is the Mahendra Singh Dhoni of our team. Okay. Similarly, we can add the before plural noun. The children love ice cream. The honesty of the poor boy helped him to get a job. The names of games. The cricket that they played was flawless. Now we are talking about particular cricket which they played. So we have used here the. Next, we do not use articles with these phrases. So, with these phrases, to take to heart, to take interest in, to make use of, from head to foot, at first sight, to be at fault, to take part in, to set aside, to take place. As well, we do not use articles in by plane, by train, in trouble, at times, all day, all night, by air, at hand, by hand, on foot, on duty, by sea, etc. So, with these phrases, we do not use articles. I hope you have understood the articles. Which are the articles? There are two kinds of articles, definite and indefinite. Definite article is the, indefinite article is a and an. The is used with both singular and plural nouns. It is also used with countable and uncountable nouns. Whereas a and an is used with singular countable nouns. A is used with the words beginning with consonant sound. An is used with the words beginning with vowel sounds. I hope you have understood the use of articles. Let us see the second type of determiner, that is demonstratives. What are demonstratives? Which words are used as demonstratives? The words like this, that, these and those, they are used as demonstratives. They are also determiners. So the words like this, that, these and those, they are demonstratives. Now we use this with singular noun which is near. This is used with singular noun which is near. That is used with singular noun which is far. These is used with plural nouns which is near, and those is used with plural nouns which are far. Okay, so this and these, they are used for nouns which are near to us. That and those are used with the nouns which are far away. This and that is used with singular, these and those is used with plural. Okay, let us see example. This glass has to be washed. So this is demonstrative which is used with singular noun glass. Now these glasses have to be washed. Now glasses is plural, so we have used here these. Now both these are near, so we have used this and these. Let us see next example. That is used before singular nouns that are farther away at distance, as I told you earlier. Those is used to point at plural nouns that are at distance. So that for singular and those for plural, which are at distance. For example, that painting is very colorful. So painting is singular and it is far, so we have used that. Those paintings are very colorful. Now those paintings is plural, so we have used those. Next, this and that may be used before uncountable nouns also. So before uncountable nouns also we can use this and that. For example, this water. Now water is uncountable. This water is clean. That cloud is floating away. Cloud is also uncountable. Okay, so this and that can also be used with uncountable nouns. I hope you have understood articles and demonstratives. In our next video, we will be continuing with possessives and distributives. Till then, be safe. Thank you.